Hello guys, welcome on my channel Crochet with Joanna. Today I'm going to show you another motif, how to crochet an Easter egg. I am using a plastic egg. This is size 12 centimeters, and this is the thread in size 10, and also I am using hook size 1.75 millimeters. I use few decorations, but it's completely up to you. For this project we have to make two the same parts, and then I'm going to show you how to join them together. Our work, we are going to start by making magic ring. So end of the yarn I will put into the back to form a little loop and cross here. Then we have to insert crochet hook into the loop, grab the yarn, and we need to work chain of 3 as a first double crochet. Then double crochet into the same ring, so we've got group of 2 double crochets at the beginning, then chain of 2. 2 double crochets into the ring, 1 and 2, then chain of 2. 2 double crochets into the ring again, 1 and 2. Then chain of 2, so we've got 3 groups of 2 double crochets so far, and we have to work another 3. 2 double crochets, 1 and 2, chain 2, then 2 double crochets, one and two, chain 2. So one more time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and one more group. 1 and 2, then chain of 2. And we have to work slip stitch in our first double crochet. So in first, chain 3. Now we can pull the tail to close our loop even more. And this is our first round. Second round, we are going to start by making chain 1, then single crochet in our first double crochet, single crochet in next stitch, then we have to work single crochet in first chain 2 space, and after first single crochet, chain of 15. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, single crochet into the same chain space, and then in next 2 double crochets, 1 and 2, single crochet in next chain space, chain of 15, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, then single crochet in the same chain space, so we should have 2 single crochets per chain space, then 1 single crochet in next 2 stitches, 1 and 2, single crochet in next chain space, then chain of 15, and the same pattern now we have to repeat all the way around. So at the end we should have 6 chain 15 spaces. At the end of our round, after the last single crochet in chain space, we have to work slip stitch into the next single crochet. And now we are going to start round number 3 by making slip stitch into the second single crochet. So into the single crochet in double crochet, then into the third single crochet, and in next 3 chain stitches. 1, 2 and 3. And now we have to start by making chain of 3 as a first double crochet. 1, 2, 3. Then 16 more double crochets in the same chain space. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, and 17. So you've got 16. 17 double crochets in total. Then we are going directly to the next chain space and we have to work 17 double crochets again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, and 17. And again, now we have to go to the next chain space and we need to work another 17 double crochets. So we have to work 17 stitches in each chain space. Round 4, after slip stitch in top of chain 3, we are going to start by making chain 1 and into the same stitch we have to work single crochet, then chain of 4. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Then we have to skip next stitch and single crochet into the second stitch, second double crochet. Chain of 4, skip next stitch, single crochet into the second, chain of 4, skip next stitch, single crochet into the second, chain 4, skip next stitch, single crochet into the second, chain 4, skip next stitch, single crochet into the second. 1, 2, 3, 4. Skip next stitch, single crochet into the second. 1, 2, 3, 4. Skip next stitch, single crochet into the second. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Skip next stitch, single crochet into the last in this part. And now we are going directly to the first double crochet in next part. And we have to start repeat exactly the same. So chain of 4, skip first double crochet, single crochet into the second. So in each part we should have 8 chain 4 spaces. And then we have to work the second part in exactly the same way, but apart from the last one round. In last one round we are going to join two pieces together by using third and fourth and fifth chain space. So basically we can start with only first three chain spaces and then we are going to join. So just finish this round, start second part and I will go back to you in a minute to show you how we need to join two pieces together. I've done my first part to the end and I've done my second part with first three chain spaces as I said before. Now we need to join the fourth and fifth chain space together with our first part. So we are going to start by making two chain stitches and then we need to find another four chain stitch in any part so far. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Make sure that you are on the right side. 1, 2, 3, 4. And now we can make slip stitch into chain space, chain of 2, and then continue with the pattern in our second part. So we have to skip first stitch and then single crochet into the second. One more time, chain of 2, then slip stitch into the next chain space, chain of 2, skip first stitch, single crochet into the second. Now we have to finish as normal, so chain of 4, skip first stitch, single crochet into the second. 1, 2, 3, 4. Skip first stitch, single crochet into the second. 1, 2, 3, 4. Skip first stitch, single crochet into the second. So into the last one in this case. Then we are going directly to the next part. And again, single crochet. Then 3, chain 4 spaces. So skip first one, single crochet into the second. 1, 2, 3, 4. Skip first, then single crochet into the second. 1, 2, 3, 4. Skip first, single crochet into the second. And now we've got our fourth chain space, so chain of 2. Then we need to find the next part. And again, we have to find fourth chain space. 1, 2, 3, 4. Slip stitch into the fourth. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Then chain of 2 and single crochet into the second. Chain of 4, chain of 2, then slip stitch into the next chain 4, then chain of 2, and then we have to skip next stitch, single crochet into the second, and now again 3 chain 4 spaces as normal to the end of this part. Then in next part we have to work another 3, and in fourth in and fifth we have to join in exactly the same way as we've done here. So the same pattern we have to continue all the way around. And now basically after third or fourth you have to put your work onto the egg to make sure that you will be able to fit the egg at the end, and then you have to finish joining on the egg. So basically that's it what I supposed to show you. Just carry on at the end, and thank you for staying with me to the end of this tutorial. I hope you enjoyed, and see you in the next one. Have a nice day.